do this as a demonstration for preparing the fiberglass. Once it's turned rock solid to the point where you can sand it, either by hand, that's a piece of 40 grit, that and whatever tool that's called, that's a piece of 60 grit, I believe. If you've got something stubborn, like a stone getting it, which is Sod's Law, you're trying to make something as flat as you can. Sod's Law, something's going to get in it. Sometimes it can be something pretty nasty. Alternatively, you can use a power sander like that. This is going to create dust. You might want to be wearing a mask. The dust will make you itch. Putting the fiberglass on didn't make your arms itch. This sanding operation is very likely to. So, good idea, just put something light on to protect your skin. The only reason I'm not wearing a mask is because I want to be able to talk to you, but here's just some of the methods I would use. I did have a demonstration over on my Facebook page about this top section where the spikes are. There's no tissue that would eliminate the spikes. So for the top, got my gloves. Always wear gloves doing this. You don't want to spike a fiberglass in your hands. So, for the top. Boom. Done. For the walls, you can pick a drop. I don't know if the camera's going to pick it up, but there's actually a drop of fiberglass. There, that's the width of the roll. So I tend to stand to the side, pick a drop, and just boom. That is done. Look up and down. Nothing nasty sticking out of it. That's fine to put the top coat on once you've wiped that over with clean acetone on a cloth. Again, wear a mask for doing that. So, yeah, happy with that. Alternative method, which I'll do only to show you whether this is faster or not. I personally think that's a slower method, and it doesn't achieve a better finish, in my opinion. Once you've done all of your walls and all of your floor in whichever method suits you, just broom it down like that. And then, like I say, get a cloth, a clean microfiber cloth or a tea towel, wipe it down with acetone, let that well evaporate you, prepare your top coat and put your top coat on. Again, just have another look at it, absolutely fine. What you don't want to do, you just turn the camera a little bit, what you don't want to do to check these things is, remember, this has not been denibbed yet. You don't want to rag your bare hand against it like that, because if there is something sharp and unpleasant that contaminated it while you were putting it on, you could open your hand up. So again, let's just use this, we'll call that a serve form, yeah? We'll see if that's a quicker method. Maybe so, maybe a tad quicker. But as always, it's not about doing things at 100 mile an hour, getting things done as fast as I can, getting to the next job. Again, quick inspection. That looks champion to me. So all of the walls are remaining to do, plus the floor, around the bottom drain, and the little spikes around your pipes. Once you've swept all that dust out, got it all nice and clean, given it all a wipe down with acetone, you'll be ready to put your top coat on. Once you've done a load of sanding like that, that's going to be full of dust. Might want to chuck that in the bin. What else is there to explain about that? Nothing really, it's quite a simple operation. Let's imagine it hasn't happened on here, but let's imagine something, I don't know, the roller picked up a stone, yeah, and it's sitting on the surface. Again, eye protection, skin protection, all that. And it won't rub out, it won't kind of rub out with that. So, pretty tentatively, kiss it down, and if you have done any damage or gone through your fiberglass because you were overzealous with that machine, just patch that up, you know. But that's, if a stone is sitting on the surface, you can work pretty accurately even with a tool like that, and literally just close up study with it and just kiss it down until you're happy with it. There are a couple of little bits in the floor that do need that kind of attention. Don't forget, I did have that cover open yesterday afternoon. Stuff did get blown into the veggie stroke bog filter kind of thing. Little bits of this is what I mean by contamination. Things getting into it, little petals of leaves and nasty things like that. They can get into your work. And then once you've put your top coat on, give that at least 24 hours or so to go off. And then you might want to come in again. Imagine that's black top coat now. Arms behind your back. Absolutely no. Even though you've done all of that nice prep work, that top coat can still get contaminated as you're putting it on. You might not be able to reach it because you've done part of your floor, yeah? So no rubbing top coat down with your hand either. Just put your hands well out the way behind your back and inspect that top coat. And if you find anything unpleasant, rinse and repeat. Oh yeah, something got in it while I was putting the top coat on. I couldn't see it because the way the light was bouncing around, just tickle them down like that. It would have to be something very nasty to have contaminated it to want to take that to it. But so, hope that helps in the prep of the fiberglass. Now, as I said, sod's law. You are trying to create something as nice as you possibly can. Sod's law, something from anywhere, all out of here, gonna get blown in and try and undo your good work. You're in the game, that's what it involves. Yeah, hope that helps. Now I'm quite happy, because I know it's been prepared properly. Put my bare hand against it. Happy with that. So there, that's out of prep, fiberglass ready for your top coat. In fact, let's do a section on the floor for you as well, so you can really see. Again, not rubbing the surface with my bare hand. Use a glove if you can feel anything. Well, even if you can't feel anything, just go over it anyway. You are not going to damage the fiberglass. You're not going to go through it with a machine like this. got what will have been a drop of fiberglass across there. I'm just going to pick that spot. Again, just as a demonstration, let's do it with that and see if this is any quicker. Again, just get the broom. Get rid of that dust. And then vacuum that out of the job. Get it into a nice little pile, vacuum it up. Now, I can quite confidently rub my hand on that surface, knowing there's nothing nasty in it that's going to spike the fish. But again, once the top coat has gone on and set hard, don't come and check it like this. Visually inspect it first. If you find something nasty got into it before it's set hard, you can just tickle it down. It's going to leave a little bit of a mark, but again, you won't damage top coat by doing that to it. So I've got the rest of this pond to do, so I shall crack on, get that done, and then we'll maybe set the camera up for the top coat or not, maybe. It is getting a bit warm now and I do have to concentrate on what I'm doing rather than looking at cameras. Right, cheers, hope that helps.